Welcome to the online lecture series of refrigeration and air conditioning. Here is Professor Lakshman Mane. This is a video session on multiple pressure refrigeration system. In this session, you will be able to explain need of multi-stage refrigeration system, multiple pressure system, cascade refrigeration system. In case of single stage vapor compression refrigeration system, these are adequate when temperature difference between evaporator and condenser is small. But in frozen food application, evaporator temperature about minus 40 degrees Celsius is required. In case of liquefaction of gases, it is up to minus 150 degrees Celsius. So in such cases, evaporator temperature decreases, so its effect is compressor discharge temperature increases. So here, as this line from 4-1 to shifts to 4-1-, thus here this 2-2" point, this is a compressor discharge temperature which is increasing. Similarly, as the line is going away from the saturated line, this point is moving in right side direction, means specific volume at the inlet of compressor increases, means size of compressor increases. Refrigerant effect, if you see here this difference, enthalpy difference, that is decreasing. And compressor work, here you can see this compressor work 1-2, 2-, this distance enthalpy difference which increases. So ultimately it reduces COP, means coefficient of performance. Throttling losses increases. Here you see throttling, this is a throttling. Superheat losses, these are the losses during superheat shown by hatching. So these are superheat losses and these are throttling losses shown by hatch line. So in such case, multi-stage compressor means multiple pressure system is used. It is used when pressure ratio of condenser to evaporator is greater than 4 or 5. Two-stage compression system is used up to minus 60 degrees Celsius temperature at evaporator, and three-stage system is used temperature below minus 60 degrees Celsius. So here are types: multiple pressure system and cascade refrigeration system. So let us take example of multiple pressure system. Here is a two-stage compression with flash gas removal with intercooler. So title clears that between two compressor, here intercooling is needful, that's why intercooler is added. And flash gas removal, because here when expansion, first expansion take place and second expansion take place, then there this is the amount of vapor removed before the second expansion. For that purpose, here flash tank is introduced. So that's why this is a case of two-stage compression with flash gas removal with intercooler. So here now we will see schematic. Let us see, here are two compressor because two stage, so compression 1 to 2, see the pH diagram 1 to 2. Second compression 4 to 5. Now exit of compressor 1, temperature or enthalpy 2 is reaching to enthalpy 4 by the intercooling 3 point. So here 2, 3 is the intercooler and 4. So 2 to 4 here reduction in enthalpy, means here desuperheating is taking place. Also temperature of exit of first compressor is reduced. and then 4 to 5 second compression take place. 5 to 6 is a condensation. 6 to 7 expansion wall 2. So 6 to 7 upper expansion. 7 to 8 here, this is a liquid removed from the flash gas. 7 to 8. So this 7 to 8 liquid removal. So this liquid, pure liquid means saturated liquid, is passed through the expansion wall, lower expansion wall. So 8 to 9 on the pH diagram expansion. Here evaporator, across this evaporator enthalpy changes from 9 to 1 point. So 9 to 1 point. Now in this case here, mass flow rate is passed through the evaporator, that is M1 dot. So this is a mass flow rate which is getting circulated in this lower part. See here, means from the flash tank M1 dot through the evaporator, through first compressor intercooler goes inside. So this is M1 dot mass flow rate. M2 dot is a flash vapor removed. This mass flow rate is passing through compressor number 2. So M2 dot is passing through second compressor. Then condenser M2 dot. So here M2 dot is circulated in upper loop and M1 dot is circulated in lower loop, lower envelope. So here are these two envelopes, 1, 2, 8, 9. And 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we need here diagram for the better understanding or to write the energy balance equation. So here we will take this flash tank. So to this flash tank, if you see here are two in. This is a in from point number 3. Second in is point number 7. So point number 7 in. And refrigerant are coming out at point number 4 vapor and point number 8 liquid. So here now we can take balance equation. Now we can write to this flash tank, heat entering is equal to heat leaving. So heat entering will be what? Mass flow rate M1, corresponding enthalpy point number 3 means H3 enthalpy. This is input. Second input is M2 dot mass flow rate, corresponding enthalpy H7. Sum of these two is equal to heat leaving. So heat leaving first, M1 dot mass flow rate leaving with H8 enthalpy plus M2 dot mass flow rate leaving with H4 enthalpy. So in this way we can write equation. Now for mass flow rate 1 we can write equation because mass flow rate M1 dot is passing through evaporator. So let us come to again diagram evaporator. Here you see across evaporator enthalpy changes 9 to 1 and mass flow rate is passing through evaporator M1 dot. So capacity of evaporator, that is QE, we can take into consideration, means TR capacity, conversion into kilowatt by using multiplier, divided by this is enthalpy difference across evaporator H1 minus H9, kg per second. This M1 dot we get here and M2 dot we can get by using this above equation. Because all the enthalpies we get from the PHR by plot. Now, once we get M1 dot, we can obtain cooling capacity of evaporator. Now, here for the compressor, two compressors. So P1 power of first compressor, P2 power of second compressor. Now, first compressor enthalpy change is H2 minus H1. And second compressor enthalpy change is H5 minus H4. let us go to the diagram. Compressor, first enthalpy change H2 minus H1. Second compressor, enthalpy change H5 minus H4. So that is what is shown here. So this mass flow rate for first compressor, this mass flow rate for second compressor. So this is total power. COP is equal to capacity in TR, conversion into kilowatt by using multiplier, divided by total power. If we want to write COP formula in the form of mass per kg, means enthalpy difference. So evaporator enthalpy difference H1 minus H9 divided by enthalpy differences in both compressors H2 minus H1, one bracket, other bracket H5 minus H4. So you can use any one formula, but the thing is that in the COP formula, numerator and denominator unit should be same, either in kilowatt or in kilojoule per kg. Next type of multi-pressure system is cascade refrigeration system. Now in this system, two vapor compression cycles are clubbed together. So here, this is a condenser line 2-3 of low temperature VCC, which is clubbed with evaporator line of high temperature VCC. So in this case, this is called as cascade condenser, cascade heat exchanger. This is called as cascading, means clubbing together. So this cascade condenser serves as an evaporator for the high temperature cascade system. And for low temperature cascade system, this becomes as a condenser. So now we can have here 1, 2, 3, 4. This is lower VCC, low temperature VCC envelope. While 5, 6, 7, 8, this is high temperature VCC cycle, that envelope is here, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now important point is here that temperature of upper VCC, evaporator temperature, that temperature is below or lower than condenser temperature of lower or low temperature VCC. Means this evaporator temperature, for example, for higher cycle is minus 30. So in that case, condenser temperature of this VCC will be 40 degrees Celsius. Not 40, below that. This is minus 30. Okay, so this condenser temperature, this hot line, refrigerant line, will give heat to this upper line. So that's why this condenser line should be hot than the evaporator line for the heat transfer. Means here, heat from the low temperature evaporator will be transferred by the compressor 1 to condenser. From the condenser, it will be received by second evaporator. Then it will be transferred by second compressor to the condenser, which is to the atmosphere. This is what cascade refrigeration system. Now for the analysis, let us take separately 1, 2, 3, 4 envelope. In this, evaporation 4 to 1. So corresponding mass flow rate through this cycle will be what? M1 dot is equal to capacity of lower evaporator TR1, multiplier conversion to kilowatt, divided by H1 minus H4. Enthalpy change. For upper VCC, mass flow rate can be written, its cooling capacity in TR multiplier for kilowatt conversion divided by this enthalpy difference of upper evaporator H5 minus H8. Now energy balance will be what? Energy balance will be what? Across this portion, means heat of 8-5 line or 5-8 line is given to 2-3 line. Hence, you will see here M1 dot mass flow rate of lower cycle multiplied by corresponding condenser enthalpy difference of lower cycle H2 minus H3 is equal to M2 dot mass flow rate circulating in upper cycle multiplied by this upper cycle evaporator enthalpy difference H5 minus H8. Now, COP can be obtained for the both cycle separately. For lower cycle 1, 2, 3, 4, COP can be written its cooling capacity multiplier divided by its mass flow rate means M1 dot into enthalpy change in compressor of cycle 1 H2 minus H1. For upper cycle here compression is 5-6. So here H6 minus H5 is the enthalpy change for upper compressor. Corresponding TR value means cooling capacity value and corresponding mass flow rate in compressor. So in this way you can write COP1 and COP2 formulae for the separate VCC. You can calculate power by multiplying mass flow rate P1 is equal to M1 dot multiplied by enthalpy difference of compression 1 H1 minus H2 H2 minus H1 here is a mistake. Please take care of this. And for P2 H6 minus H5 enthalpy difference multiplied by corresponding mass flow rate. So at the end of this session you can explain need of multi-stage refrigeration system, multiple pressure system and cascade refrigeration system. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.